Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Today's topic is seventh lecture of Fourier transform. The topic is one of the properties of Fourier transform, convolution property. Okay, what is convolution property? Now here this is time domain, here is frequency domain. You can see here this kind of a convolution correspond to the multiplication in frequency domain. We call this convolution property of Fourier transform. This is a continuous case. This is the discrete time signals systems. Let me prove this. Okay, therefore Fourier transform of x over t convolution h of t. Now this is a convolution formula, and this is the Fourier transform formula. From this is the function of time, this function of time. Therefore we can interchange like this. This is a function of time, another one is a tower. Here we can change this variable p, this h of p, and then we make this one. Then here you can see here the integral, this integrable variable, the variable integral is p, therefore this is a constant, one of the constant. Then we can, this term, they go out here. Then you can see here this term and this term. This term is Fourier transform over h omega, and this is the Fourier transform over x omega. Finally, we can get Fourier transform of convolution is, this is a multiplication of frequency domain. Okay, let me take some examples. First, x over t, h over t equal del t minus t zero, then y t. How to get y over t? Okay, there are two ways. One is the convolution in time domain. Another one is a multiplication in frequency domain. Okay, first, convolution. This convolution, y over t equal convolution x over t, convolution h over t, by formula like this. Then x over tau here, this is the t, instead of t, we can substitute t minus t zero, minus t zero. And the variable this integral is tau, therefore this equal tau equal t minus t zero, this value equal 1, otherwise all 0, therefore tau goes to here, we can get x t minus t zero, can get here. Next, multiplication means from y omega we can get y of t by inverse Fourier transform. The y omega means like this, y omega means x omega into h omega. X omega means Fourier transform x omega, and h omega means Fourier transform h of t equal this. This is the, by the shifting properties here, my lecture 29, we can get this one. Therefore x is equal this one. This is a time shifting properties. We can get y of t equal x t minus t zero. Where we can get same result by the convolution and the multiplication. Also in this case, same problem examples. This is discrete time case. X of n, h of n, and the y of n. Also two ways for getting the y of n. Convolution and multiplication. Convolution means y of n equal x of n convolution h of n. By formula we can do this. x of k and h n minus k means here instead of n you can get n minus k minus n zero. Then this is a delta function. Now here also variable of summation is k, therefore here k equal n minus n zero, this value equal 1, therefore xn minus n zero. can get this result. Then multiplication method equal also y omega. From omega we can get y of n by inverse Fourier transform. Then y omega means x omega into h omega. Then x omega, h omega means Fourier transform of h of n, h of n equal del n minus 0. By using this shifting time properties, h omega equal like this. Then we substitute this one. This is the one of the properties of time shift. Shifting times the property, we can get y of n equal x n minus n 0. Then we can get same result. Okay, this is a little bit more complicated question. Examples: continuous time signal case. X of t equal this, h of t equal this, then y of t. Also, convolution method and the multiplication method. First, convolution: x y of t equal x of t convolution h of t equal by formula this one. Then x omega, x tau means now here instead of tau, there this one, tau. And h t means t minus t, t minus tau. Therefore, here, this one, and this one. Can get. From this, now the variable of integral is tau. Therefore, this term is constant. Therefore, we can take out of this integral like this. We can go this one, and we can see this one. You can see, you can get this what? Now, pay attention to this term. This term, okay. Now you see here, u of tau. This term is u of tau. Then u t minus tau means here. This t equal less than 0, then this into this means green and red. Now here, any t equal or t less than 0, this in red into green means you can see a 0. Then this I'm going to move here, then the t is greater than 0 like this 0. Then this part is all zero, this is also. Therefore, we can integrate zero to t e minus t. Then from this, we can get this result. Okay, this is t minus t is greater than zero. Means also you can also write. And multiplication, y over omega to y over t by inverse Fourier transform. Then y omega means x omega into h omega. X omega means from this 1 by b plus a omega by using this formula. And h omega equal also 1 by a plus a omega. Then this into this term. From this, we want to use this formula. We need to separate partial fraction this and this. And we can get a and b, then 1 minus a minus b by this one. From this, we can y over t by inverse Fourier transform. This is constant. Okay. This you can see here, inverse means this one, therefore e minus bt minus e minus bt. This is u over t equal here. Now you see, you can get same result. Next, all the discrete time signals. X of n equal a to the power n u of n. H of n equal b to the power of n u of n. Then the y of n. Also, convolution and the multiplication methods. Convolution means y of n equal x of n convolution h of n. By formula, we can write this one. Then x of k, this is k. Now you can see here. And this is instead of n, we can use n minus k here, n minus k here. You can do that. Okay, also here, the variable summation k, therefore, this term is constant, therefore, we can take out our summation here, and the remaining part is this one. Okay, now here, let's pay attention to this term. Now, u of k equal this, and n less than 0, u of n minus k is like this. This is n equal to 0. Then you can see red into blue. Red into blue, 0 into 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, or 0 equal, you can get 0. Then this n minus k moved to here. This means n greater than 0, n greater than 0. Then y of n equal, or this part is 0. Then we can summation just this area. Therefore, 0 to n, like this one. From this, we can get this result. Then multiplication also, y omega. Y omega, we can get y of n by inverse Fourier transform. Then y omega equal x omega into h omega. X omega means from this, we using the by this formula, 1 minus 1 by 1 minus a exponential to the power of j omega, and 1 by 1 minus b e to the power of minus j omega. From this also, we can separate partial fraction at this one, this this one. Then now we can we need to inverse Fourier transform. From this, y of t, y of n equal here inverse. Then this one and this one. From this now here, from this we know this one. This means this one. From this we can get same one. That's it. One same result. Okay, thank you so much for your watching. Today I have explained second lecture of properties of Fourier transform. The convolution in time domain corresponds to the multiplication in frequency domain, and some examples. Next topic is third properties of Fourier transform: linearity, time reversal, differential in continuous time systems, difference in discrete time systems, multiplication, Parseval's relations. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.